Hello everyone, in this video we're going to solve a Rankine cycle step by step. This video is linked to our previous video on Rankine cycles, so I advise you to watch it before watching this one. If you've watched our previous video on the Rankine cycle, we learned about each component of the cycle and how to calculate the main parameters. So let's put it to practice now. We have this simple Rankine cycle here, okay? We know the pressure and quality of the vapor in the inlet of the turbine. We know also the quality and the pressure on the in the outlet of the condenser, okay? And it's a 100 megawatt cycle. So we want to find the thermal efficiency, the back work ratio, the mass flow rate of the steam, the rate of heat transfer to the working fluid as it passes through the boiler, in other words, the heat transferred in the cycle, and also the rate of heat transfer from the condensing steam as it passes through the condenser, in other words, the heat transferred out of the cycle. Alright, so here's a pro tip for you. So anytime you want to solve a thermodynamic cycle, you have to start from determining the thermodynamic states, okay? Before trying to calculate any type of work efficiency, determine all the thermodynamic states in the cycle, alright? We can start from the inlet of the turbine, state number one. There we know the pressure and we know the quality, that's saturated vapor. From these two informations here, you can look for the enthalpy and entropy in any thermodynamic table that we have in books. And well, we have several computer softwares to find it for you. And we have several online tables, okay? So you can just insert the quality, saturated vapor, and the pressure there, and you can find these two properties. The tables looks like this, okay? So we have some of the properties here for saturated water, right? Have the specific volume, internal energy, enthalpy, entropy, and it's related to the pressure and temperature, right? So from these tables here, we get these values. Right, so we have now state number one, let's go to state number two. There, we have the pressure, right, at the inlet of the condenser. We know that is the same of the outlet, because the condenser works at constant pressure, alright? And it's we're considering an internal reversible expansion through the turbine, okay? So the pressure there is 0.008 megapascal. So using all the same tables, okay, for now for saturated liquid and saturated vapor, we can find the quality of the state 2. Remember that state 2, when it leaves the turbine, we have a mixture of liquid water and vapor, right? So we need to find the quality. So for the from the tables, we have S2, okay? We have S for the fluid, we have the entropy, I'm talking S is entropy, okay? For the gas, and the entropy for the fluid here is an interpolation, right? So we find that the quality is 0.6745. From the quality, we can use this formula here to find the enthalpy for state number two. So we have the enthalpy for the fluid, okay, plus the quality times the enthalpy for the fluid and gas. Alright? Here, these values, remember, we find in the tables, the thermodynamic tables, okay? So from the quality, we find the enthalpy at state number two, okay? Okay, let's keep going then for state number 3, when it leaves the condenser. Okay, when we leave the condenser, we need to have saturated liquids because it's going to enter the pump. We can only pump liquid, okay? No vapor can enter a pump, so it needs to be at least saturated liquid. And we have the pressure there. So from the thermodynamic tables, we find H3, okay? The enthalpy at point at state 3. For state 4, we're leaving the pump. So the pressure there is the pressure we need for the boiler, which is P4, okay? Which is 8 megapascal, okay? And for the pump, we consider for the pump and for the turbine in this case a isoentropic efficiency, okay? It means it's like a perfect pump for this case, right? So the entropy entering and is the same as the entropy leaving the pump, okay? So from this we can find H4, the entropy at 0.4, which is entropy at 0.3, plus this expression here. Remember, for the pump we can use the specific volume and difference in pressure, okay? You can watch our previous video and take a look into this specific formula here, all right? So from this, we have these values from the thermodynamic tables, okay? The specific volume, and we can find the state 4, the enthalpy for state 4. Now we have all the states, the thermodynamic states determined, and we can move on. Okay, now it's easy, we just need to solve the cycle. So for the thermal efficiency, we have the thermal efficiency formula, okay? We have all the enthalpies. So we find, we just add the enthalpies here from states 1, 2, 3, and 4, and find a thermal efficiency of 37.1%. For the back work ratio, the same thing. We have the formula, we have all the enthalpies, so we can just add the values and find a back work ratio of 0.84%. So see how much easy it is when we determine all the states first. That's why we did all that work before, okay? Moving on, the mass flow rate. We can use the power of the cycle, the net power, okay? Which is the power of the turbine minus the pump, okay? To find the mass flow rate. We have the enthalpies. We have that the a cycle produces 100 megawatts hour, all right? That's why I'm doing this conversion here. 1 hour has 3,600 seconds, okay? We have all the enthalpies, and we find that the mass flow rate is 3.77 times 10 to the fifth kilograms per hour, okay? This conversion here just to transform everything to hours, all right? The heat transfer from the boiler, the same thing, we have the heat transferred in the system, we have the enthalpies for the states, we have the mass flow now, we can find that the heat transferred in the system, in the cycle from the boiler is 269.77 megawatts, all right? Here again, I'm adding this conversion because here is kilograms per hour, but for watts, we need seconds, okay? From the condenser, the heat transferred out of our cycle is the same thing, okay? We have the enthalpies already, and we find our heat transferred from the condenser out of the system.
Physics doesn't have to be hard. Subscribe to our channel and learn with the geeks.